Let's see if this one opens. Could this place really be a fallen ruin?
You could hardly call it a ruin. It's perfect. Like it was built yesterday.
Have you ever seen anything like this?
Me.
What do we do?
The usual. Things still function.
How can any of this? This must be what the fallen ruins were like before they fell.
good on you.
And he told me next time, Tai-on, he was so cute. He was asking me where I work. I was like, I sell ties. Come in and get a tie. I told him I used to work at Men's Warehouse. He said, this is from Men's Warehouse. I said, they look good on you. And he told me next time, I shouldn't go to court. I should just not pay them. So I'm going to trust him. He was like, it's your birthday today. And you know what? It is my birthday today. Happy birthday to me. I got it, dude. I got it.
Looks like he can take a beating.
Then let's give it one. Any of this makes sense to you?
None. Let's find the hooded man and leave.
Would Joshua have had to run this gauntlet too?
No. At least not that I ever heard about. I imagine the Phoenix would receive a warmer welcome.
Here we go again. Where will we end up this time?
Surrounded by contraptions hell-bent on murdering us, I expect. Could the Hooded Man really have taken this path?
We won't know until we've followed it all the way to the end. Come on, let's keep looking.
Yeah!
like this.
feeling's mutual. It's done.
What are these creatures? And why do they keep attacking us?
They're probably asking themselves the same thing. We're the ones trespassing here. They're just protecting their home. Jill, look.
Is that some kind of mural?
It's worth a closer look, whatever it is. right then.
It would seem this place holds even more secrets than we thought.
Did something. Here.
Another fallen wonder.
Hi, hello, sorry, I was handling some business. Talking to folk. Sorry if you're listening and you can hear me. I'm actually replaying a mission I've already finished. Because this is where some of the really serious story stuff happens. Honestly, it's a very pivotal moment in my whole story. But the first time I played it, EJ and Beth were in here watching me. And they were extremely distracting. So I'm going back to play it again. Because I want to see it without anybody bothering me. So, perfect timing. You're gonna see a bunch of important stuff happen. And then after this, I'm actually gonna replay another level because some more important stuff happens involving Sid. If you remember who Sid is, Sid is the very deep voiced man. I kind of gave you a little bit of a rundown last time about what was happening in the story. So up to this point, if you remember, you know, just a quick recap. The whole thing with my brother dying and my dad, yada, yada, yada. I did tell you what was happening with the whole Joshua thing, you know, Clive's brother, as far as Clive's brother turns out to actually be alive. Clive's brother turned out to also be the hooded man that we've been after this whole time, who we thought killed Clive's brother. You know, take that as you will, it's kind of wild. I don't really know what's happening there. There have been other developments that I've witnessed since then, but that's before, or that's after this part right here. So the whole thing with Joshua, we're here because we came, this is Phoenix Gate. So right now where we're at is Phoenix Gate, which is where everything happened all those years ago. This is where the big battle happened, where we saw Joshua die, and everybody was murdered, and there was a big explosion, and the entire castle was destroyed. This is the sanctum, like, beneath the castle, where Joshua was supposed to be going that day, because this is where, like, the Phoenix has to come and do his, like, rituals and stuff. But that never happened, because everything was crazy.
It isn't a dead end after all.
Apparently not.
So, with that being said, we're here because Clive wants to find out the truth about who he really is and what the heck actually happened that day and what the heck is going on. Because remember I told you there was some stuff where Clive turned into that very big giant beast, which is the same beast that killed his brother. So now Clive's been going around thinking that maybe he's been the murderer this whole time, and he's like, that doesn't make any sense, but it's gotta be me, because who else would it have been? Because, you know, yada yada yada. So now we're here because they're like, cool, me and Joel are like, let's go back to where it all started, where it all happened, and see if we can find out the truth. The hooded man is here, aka Joshua. We've seen him. We don't know where he went, but we followed him and then he came here. So now this is where Clive is gonna find out the truth about what's going on. And so you get to see that very pivotal moment happen. So enjoy. It's funny because I got Beth really, really invested in the story, and so when she was here last time, she kept asking me to play the game because she was like, honestly, I just want to watch you play. So that's why I was playing for them, because Beth specifically asked me to play. She's like, damn, I'm really invested now. I want to see what's happening.
It all seems to lead to this room.
And then they proceeded to distract me. So I'm replaying those. Like, I'm playing this, and then after this, I'll replay another very, very critical scene. So you'll get to see both the very important moments, and you'll kind of be caught up as to what's going on in this very Game of Thrones Final Fantasy story.
How old do you suppose this is?
But like I said, right now we're in like the ritual area for the phoenix, which is what Joshua was, the phoenix.
I've never seen anything like
it. So only the phoenix is supposed to be able to get in here. The only reason I was able to get in here is because I have part of the phoenix in me.
Some sort of god.
I don't know if you're listening or not, or if you're even there, but just give me a little wave if you are. I assume you are. Just so I know I'm not talking to myself. Oh, sorry, I'm pausing it. I need to do something real quick. I need to check something. Testing. Cool. Okay. I was adjusting my mic level.
You're him. The second dominant of fire. Who are you?
Pausing one more time. Okay. They're really making us relive that moment.
Stop it! Please! Stop!
Fucking, I mean, that feels so bad for you, dude.
Joshua chose me to be his shield. He gave me his blessing and asked me to keep him safe. I should have protected him that day. It was my duty.
Clive.
Joshua died. I killed him.
It gives me chills.
I blamed another for what I did. To spare myself the guilt. I feared that by accepting it, I would lose what little was left of me. So I ran. From everything. And now? Are you ready to accept the truth? I am. I know it won't be easy, but it's what I must do. So that Joshua's soul can finally rest in peace.
Here we go. This should be easier to do the second time around.
To the truth that awaits me. I will press on. Come, Ifrit. Show me who you truly are.
Oh. I forgot I could change my abilities on the fly. Oh, never mind. I lied. I can't change it. Get out.
Yeah.
Excuse me. Turn off switch. Good job. Now let's hit him with the big moves. Good job. We did it. Oh, I think I know what you're talking about. You're talking about Titus, aren't you? You said Tyson, but I'm assuming you're probably talking about Titus. Oh, I'm amazing. I can't even do that. If he is in the military, honestly, I have no clue. I don't even think I follow Titus on Snap. If I do, I never see his post. The baby is, but if he is, I didn't know that. Oh my god! Jesus Christ! I almost died. Whew! Good job. Get him, good job. Oh my god. Okay, I'm back. I literally paused just so I could look at your snap. Yes, the game is very beautiful. Maybe you just need a better TV. Granted, it is a little dark sometimes, but I did turn the brightness up, like, in the game itself. And honestly, it's been perfect ever since. But maybe your TV is just a little dark. But anyways, yeah, it's a beautiful, very beautiful game. Also, trust me, even for me, like, sometimes the fighting and the combat and stuff, there's so much going on. Like, it's pretty seeing all the particles and seeing all the powers and all that stuff. But I'm like, dang, sometimes I'm like, bro, what is happening? I'm just hitting. I'm like, I'm just swinging. At this point, I don't even know what I'm doing because there's so much happening. I did it, and I killed myself.
No escape, eh? It's all right. I'm done running from you.
He's done running from his past. Running from himself.
Together. It's time to find out who we are. Once and for all.
I love that so much. And it's like, you can feel it in the controller. The controller's literally, like, making a heartbeat. Like my controller's beating like a heart right now. That's so cool. Time to accept the truth. Of who I really am. I'm a murderer. Staggered them already. I'm incredible. Let's go! I'm doing so much damage. That was insane. I can't believe that. It would have been hilarious if his body fell to the ground and he just exploded. Because I feel like games do those unnecessary explosions in the background so much. And movies. You know how those action movies would just have a random explosion in the background while you walk away. We did it. We killed ourselves. Good job, Clive. Jesus.
Clive, are you all right?
Jill. It's nothing. I'll be fine.
Now he knows the truth. He is Ifrit. He is the one who killed his own brother all those years ago.
No more chasing shadows. The hooded man isn't here. We should go.
He just didn't know it, but also he kind of knew and just denied it because he's like, well, that's impossible. It couldn't have been me. But he awakened as the dominant Ifrit that day and just didn't know. Because also, that shouldn't even be possible. Because there's only supposed to be one fire dominant, and that was Joshua, the Phoenix. But now there's two.
Are you sure you're all right? Whatever it is, you can tell me.
Now everyone's confused.
I had a hard enough time telling myself. I awakened as a dominant of fire, right here in this castle. And I've been running from it ever since. But now I know for certain who I really am. The second Icon of Fire, who killed my brother and burned this castle to the ground, was me. Ifrit.
Clive.
I took so many lives that night, and destroyed so many more, including yours. And I must atone for the crimes I've committed. But not before I learn the whole truth. How can a second Icon of Fire even exist? And why was I chosen as its dominant? Who is the hooded man who brought us here? And what does he want? I need to know. And since I'm still breathing, I might as well make myself useful.
We'll find your answers together. I want to learn the truth too.
Yeah, you do. She's so cute.
There'll be time enough for atonement when we're done.
I was hoping you'd say that. I don't think I could do this without you. You never were one to hide from the truth, even when we were young. And you haven't changed a bit.
You're wrong. I have changed. But I don't want to be that person anymore. The things she did were unforgivable. And yet, they're what brought us back together.
Now, kiss. Actually, don't kiss. Just hug or something. Shake hands. I don't know. There he is. There's the
if
boy.
He's here, then. The disturbance I felt at the care must have been.
There's Joshua.
The hour is later than I thought.
Okay, so that chapter's done. So what I'm going to do next is replay the other chapter I was talking about. So fast forward a little bit. Where are we going? We're going here, to Drake's Head. Fast forward a little bit after that whole event, right? So we return to the hideout. Clive and Jill explain to Cid what happened and who Clive is, and Cid's like, cool, you know, I understand. I'm a dominant too. It's tough. I get it. Blah, 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 blah. Whatever. And then Cid, you know, talks to them for a little while. And then Jill and Clive, like, basically pledge themselves to Cid's cause. And, you know, Cid's going around trying to free all of the slaves, all the bearers, and the people with the mark on their face. Because they're all slaves or whatever, and the dominants. He wants everybody to be free, and he wants to rid the world of the system that they're in, blah, 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 blah. So they pledge themselves to Cid's cause, and now they're traveling around with Cid, trying to help free people, right? So there comes a time where Cid finds out, obviously the world's full of magic. I told you about the big, large crystals that are around. So there's the 4 or 5 crystals, like large crystals, that basically give everybody their magic, and it's what the world is run on, or at least what their country's run on. And so they use the crystals for everything. The problem with the crystals, Cid finds out something about the crystals that the government and everybody has been hiding the truth about. And it's the fact that there's this thing going around the country called the Blight. It's basically this thing that's like sucking life from the earth. And just anywhere where the Blight spreads, like, the land is just uninhabitable. Come to find out that the way that the crystals work and the way that they've been sucking power from things, and after all the time that we've been using them, the large crystals are part of the reason why the earth is dying. And the higher ups know this, they just have not told the general public, because they're like, well, we're using the crystals for power and we're using it for this and that and the other, so sure, the earth is dying, but who cares? You know, sounds familiar. Big corporate, big business. So Cid's like, listen, Clive, We need to destroy one of the great crystals and send a message, but also save lives and yada yada yada. So they're like, what better crystal to take out than the one at literally the capital of the country? Like the biggest one. So like, cool, we're gonna go do that. And we're gonna free these slaves. We're gonna take out that crystal and we're gonna save, you know, whatever is happening with the blight and whatever. We're gonna try to break this system that the hierarchy and the higher ups have been trying to keep us under captives of too long. So that's what this chapter is about to be about. And it's very important because this chapter is honestly like crazy pivotal. I mean, what we just did was pivotal, but like, this is another like really major moment. And so if you're still watching, I'm about to play that chapter because that was the other one that they were kind of distracting me while I was trying to play it. There was a lot happening here. So I'm about to do that one. Before I do that, I need to pause for just a few minutes and I will be right back if you're listening. I'll snap you. 1 second. I'm back. Okay, I'll do this one. I think this one's probably about as long as that last one was. Granted, you also walked, or you came in the stream and I was like halfway through with that one, so like... this one, depending on where they start me from, if they start me from the beginning of it, it's not that long. So that's why I say it's probably about as long as the other one was. But if they start me in the middle of it where I think they're going to start me from, I kind of hope they do. Oh, nope, they're starting me from the beginning. That's fine. Again, I've already done all this, and they let me keep my current abilities and my level, so I'm actually overpowered for this section now. So I can actually get through it a little quicker. And because I know what I'm doing, it should be faster. But look, we're here with Sid now. And many things are about to happen. And it's fortunate the city many very important things that honestly change the trajectory of the story.
This bodes well.
I'll be a first. This may not be such a terrible plan after all.
And what exactly is that supposed to mean?
Only that your last secret shortcut was nowhere near as secret as you claimed.
Yeah, well, that's half the fun of it. Life's too short for perfect plans. You want a plan that'll keep you on your toes, stop you growing old and complacent.
Worked for you, has it?
Clive, my boy. Even life's smallest challenges offer the opportunity to grow and to change. You must embrace these moments.
I love Sid.
To suffuse your heart with a deep sense of fulfillment.
Narrowly escaping death at the hands of an enemy is not my idea of fulfillment.
Something wrong?
Not at all. Just wondering if the two of you had finished.
Right. We make for the Mother Crystal's heart as planned. Destroy it, and the whole thing should come tumbling down.
So yeah, Serrano went to destroy the Mother Crystal in the capital.
Then we embrace the moment and use it to grow and change. Come on, this way. Try to stay out of sight.
Oh gosh, man.
Obviously.
I'm just thinking about what's about to happen in this section. Oh my god, what an emotional journey that was. This is very interesting. And I'm still not even halfway done with this game. Is there anything down there? No, she's a treasure chest. I don't need to go anywhere.
All right, not quite empty. Let's get this over with.
Let's see all men for reaching the sanctum, so shut your gob and keep your eyes open.
All right, fine.
They're not from the garrison.
I swear this passage used to be secret.
Of course it did.
Perfect plans, right? Perfect plans.
I mean, there is definitely a reason why it's not secret at all. Okay. Yeah, I should be able to fly through this section.
They never stood a chance.
You're welcome.
The main tunnel.
That would be my guess. There are sentries everywhere.
Thank you.
And all good things must come to an end. We might have a bit more company from now on.
Captain!
To arms!
This might take a while.
Level the cannonade!
It's over.
Really?
The moment I was talking about earlier.
What have we here? More insects come to be squashed? You will find my mortar and I only too happy to oblige.
You a talker?
Then let's shut him up.
Jesus, I thought I got out the way. So right now they're talking about ether. Ether is the stuff that the mother crystals give off, and it's where we get our power from. So basically, too much ether can be a very, very bad thing. For humans and for the planet. Which is why we're destroying it. I forgot I could use my ether powers, man. Count to that last captain. They give you the power to be able to use your dominant powers, like my ether powers! So I can do this now. Got him.
He's gonna catch you.
Poor wretch.
I completely forgot about the second part of this fight.
You'll get none in return. There's nothing left of him but hatred and rage.
Let's end his torment.
We did it. Doesn't matter.
I'll never get used to that. The Kashiko know he was still a man. A man who drowned in ether.
It's no way for anyone to go.
Come on.
Guard duty's a death sentence in this place. Not that Sylvester cares.
So, update. All this blue stuff you see around us is all ether coming from the butter crystals. So, basically, if a human takes on too much ether like this and exposed to too much ether, which is what happened to that guy we just fought, just think of them as the White Walkers from Game of Thrones. They turn blue. They're not necessarily undead, but they are, like, corrupted to the point of no return. Like, they're practically not human anymore once they've gotten exposed to all this stuff. And so that's been happening to people who come down here, apparently. And he's not the only one. But that's why that's one of the reasons why we're trying to destroy the Mother Crystal, to get rid of all this.
It's a blessing, my friends. You said being a dominant doesn't have its benefits.
But being a dominant, we aren't affected. We aren't affected by the ether.
There should be one here, should there? The workers couldn't survive this.
Well, it wasn't here last time, I can tell you that. Which means we need to be quick. The ether won't hurt us, but I'd rather not find out what it's done to everyone else.
Cool. Who better can explain it than Cid himself? Also, what are you reading? And I assume it's that nerd book, the one that's related to, you know, the one about the women. Little Women. Little Women. There we go. I'm assuming that's what you're reading.
The miners. The guards.
Too far gone. The Aether's made monsters of them. All we can do now is put them out of their misery.
Yep. I'm fighting the White Walkers.
Could this be why?
What? You said you could call Elizabeth. Never mind. If ever there was a reason to open this, an Aether Club would be it. Oh, me. Those guards at the gate. They weren't there to keep people out.
They were there to keep the Akashic in.
So instead of calling them the White Walkers, they call them the Akashic. But anyways, dang. See, I missed that the first time. So I didn't even realize that the people here who live at the capital were planning on leaving the capital. Obviously, they probably didn't tell all the townsfolk why, but they were planning on abandoning the capital and moving somewhere else. That makes sense. There's another scene where you see, the king having a meeting with people, and he talks about, how they need to expand their territory and yada yada yada. And I guarantee that this is probably part of the reason. Huh. They're not just simply expanding their territory. They're like, yo, we gotta get the heck out of here. Interesting. Okay, we came from that way. So that's why this isn't a secret passage anymore, because they have guards at the entrance trying to keep all these White Walkers in here.
Doesn't look that far. Right. Some help.
Hold on.
Not quite as spry as I used to be.
I'll take that as a thank you.
Look on the bright side, eh? At least you won't get lost. Hmm.
Making sure I'm going the right way. Oh my god, I just looking at your snap, and you said the exact same thing that Beth said when she was watching. She was like, Jill did absolutely nothing. And I was like, don't worry, it's because she had to stand there and watch the dog. She's taking care of Torvald. Seems like about to die, and Jill just did not help. That is hilarious. Y'all both said the same thing. I mean, you're not wrong. That's funny. Oh god, not this dude again. I broke his dagger twice. That's amazing.
I see they replaced that wooden door with something a little more sturdy.
Hey, 1 second. I need to pause real quick again.
Chapter 3.
What happened to two?
Ask one.
Once more.
I love that joke.
Aye, seeing as you're trying now. If that was going to keep us out. The mother crystal's just up ahead.
Is it? I can't see a thing.
Well, unless someone's moved it.
Okay, this is where things get interesting.
There's no one about.
I knew it would be big. But this...
Here's the base of the Mother Crystal.
There. That's our way into the Inner Sanctum. Patch that up by now. Sorry, state the Empire's in.
Wait. You don't mean...
Aye. My little game of hide-and-seek with Bahamut ended here. At tragic cost to this remarkable architecture. Don't blame me, he started it.
But how did he make it out alive?
So Cid actually fought another dominant person here. Apparently.
You should try it.
I walked. Okay, this is where all the serious stuff's about to happen. That crystal's so freaking pretty, bro. Like, I wish you could see it from the outside. It looks gorgeous outside of the capital. It's like that view is insane.
Stay down.
could those creatures from Phoenix Gate be here in the mines?
Are the two places connected somehow?
Oh my god, I'm just now, I'm remembering all the stuff that's about to happen. I'm like, okay, there's more that happens here than I thought there was, and I remember, which is why I'm replaying it. Oh. Alright, broskies. I need to kill the one giving y'all extra power. Jesus. Clive, please. Good job. Who's healing? Somebody's healing. Oh, I think we killed him. Interesting. Does that not do what I thought it did? Huh, maybe I missed something.
When I was in the Imperial Army, soldiers assigned to the Glass Gate would tell stories about something they called the Guardian.
Can't say I saw anything like that when I was last here. Then again, I can't say I made it this far.
Let's just be careful then.
Sounds like a warning if I've ever heard one. Look at all that crystal, bro. So cool. Again, I wish you could see it from the outside. It looks so good on the outside. Alright, guys.
Where did that come from?
It's a White Walker dragon. It's Daenerys' dragon that died and then went to the White Walker side.
Poor beast. Another victim of the flood.
Well, if it's a fight he wants.
Ready, Clive?
Always.
Crap, I forgot to change my attacks again. This would be better suited for this fight. What? God.
Clive, look out!
Good job.
Yeah!
Good job. So much damage. We needed that. Oh! We got him. Definitely got him.
Flames to me.
Jesus! Please! That was not good! This is very bad. Oh, I killed him. I never realized how low his health was. Well, good job. Alright, this is where all the fancy, weird... This is where the story gets crazy. This is where everything is about to change.
Are you all right?
Fine.
The inner sanctum lies just beyond. Chances are the palace guard knows we're here. We should move. Not that any sane commander would send his men into a place awash with this much ether. Clive. If this all works and the blasting fades, things are likely to get worse for our kind before they get better. Being the last to wield ether will make our talents that much more sought after, by which I mean hunted. I just hope, in the end, they'll see that we didn't have any other choice, that it was the only way to get us to a better place.
And here I was thinking I was the uncertain one. Luckily, two out of three of us have faith in you.
Then it all starts here. Time to earn that menacing title. Sid the Vicious, was it?
Ah, here we go.
We're almost. What's there? Anyone having second thoughts?
Not me.
We're with you to the end, Sid.
Then what are we waiting for?
They really gave me so many regular potions, bro. Where are the high potions at? I wish I could just craft them in my inventory. Wouldn't that be great? Wouldn't that be amazing? Okay, let's do this.
Beautiful.
The heart of Zambrek.
Well, that didn't work. I think we're gonna need a bigger sword.
Mine's bigger.
Thank you, Clive. Figuratively. The core's clearly made of sterner stuff.
Mine's bigger. Clive's so funny, unintentionally.
Taya's going to have a fit when she hears about this. Stand back. It's about to get cramped in here.
Do you think, Sid? Old man soon.
That's more like it.
Clive, look.
What is that?
Bro, this was crazy.
Sid!
Creepy! It's horrible.
Hold on.
Well, the first time that thing showed up, I was like, yo, what is this creepy ass? It stuck him to the wall. Bro, that's so creepy.
I've been here before.
This insolence shall not go unpunished.
Will we?
Dominant.
You again. Where are you? What do you want? Fuck. It's still alive.
Bro trying to pull himself free. Jesus. Get him! Get him! Get them all! Get them all! Dang, my gun is still going. Oh my god! Oh my god! Now that I'm so much stronger, this is so much easier to do. There we go. Well.
And yours.
Do it, Clive. Do it, Clive.
But this is mine.
Fire.
Oh, this is so freaking cool. Job. What are you doing? Get down! Oh my god! Okay. Jesus Christ! Good job. Get in there. That's what I'm talking about. Nice. Alright. Oh! Dodge. I get fit and dodge. It's fine, he's almost dead. Ah, good job! You're incredible, Clive. Ow! Just give it up, bro. You're about to die anyway. Oh, shoot. Nope. Get in there. Got him.
It's done.
Someone showed up to watch and then they left. I can't see, it's too bright. Yes, four arms now. And blonde hair. Jesus! Oh no, the other person left. Oh no. Get out. Oh my gosh, whatever. Good job. Middle, right, left, straight. Nope. Can't believe I died, folks. This is so freaking cool, bro. My ultimate move. Bro, what a game. What a freaking game this is. What a game. Most suitable vessel. Vessel. I just realized what he said. All right, this is where more important things happen.
Clive.
Well, enjoy your nap.
You're wounded.
This, it's only a scratch. All right, the hole.
We'll find you a healer.
Here. No, you won't.
Ah, good old Sid. That's not creepy. Now we shall become one.
I know who you are. And if you think I'm gonna let you have him. Think again.
Why do you deny your fate, your purpose?
Sid.
One left. That'll do me.
Try not to talk.
Clive. For so long, I thought I had all the answers. But then I met you. And I learned it wasn't a good death we should be fighting for, but a better life. It's all very well, a man reclaiming his fate. But if he can't choose how he meets it, what's the point? So, I made a choice. Crystal's blessing is a prison, Clive. And if it's an outlaw the world needs to help it break free. Stop. Please. I can think of none better than you.
Poor Clive, bro. I mean, poor Sid, but poor Clive. This is how you would waste your will. Perhaps it's time to land. Your place in this grand scheme.
In ashen grip. Let ember glow to kindle flames anew.
The Phoenix is here.
Sorry, Clive. Had I arrived but a moment sooner. Do you remember me, boy? I saw you protect them. That was very brave. I know you're there, Ultima.
Oh. You have learned our name. What else have you learned, Phoenix?
Dude's so creepy.
My travels have revealed much about you and your ambitions. I know that it was you who tore me from my brother. And I know that it is his power that you seek. But know this. If you want him, you'll have to go through me.
Bro, they made him look so good.
Breath of mine ancestors.
These graphics are insane.
Fill these lungs that I may dispel the songs of suffering.
A disturbance.
This is getting us nowhere.
We agree. No more games, Phoenix. We are come to claim our vessel.
And I said no.
Flames are nothing. You will know what it is to burn.
Yours is a fleeting form. I'm not fool enough to think I can harm you. But to protect my brother, I don't have to.
Yes, Clive. Look, see your brother. Look at him. Look at him. I love that moment.
These are not flames of destruction.
Have you forgotten already who I am?
That's cool. There's the mother crystal disappearing. That's crazy. This game's so freaking gorgeous, bro. It's gone. What are the people gonna do now? Oh, really? The chapter just ends there? Oh my gosh. Alright, well, I'm not gonna play this chapter. I only wanted to do those two. Man, what a story. That's so crazy. So I literally just replaying those stories, those chapters. So now, fast forward even more. So you just saw all of that just happened, right? So after that moment, literally there's a time skip of like 5 years go by, and then you see Clive and Jill in like another country talking to some people or whatever. Or not talking to some people. They're like infiltrating the city, and they're like trying to rescue more of like the bears or whatever, and they like attack this group of army guys or whatever, group of soldiers. So what's currently happening, which is where I'm at right now in the game after the time skip, because that whole big event was the last thing I did for the most part. That was the last major thing I did. So fast forward 5 years, present time, Clive and Jill have now taken on Cid's duties because Cid's dead. So for the past 5 years, they have been freeing the bears and freeing the captives and slaves and stuff. And they're still planning out how they're going to destroy the other mother crystals, because that was just one, obviously. There's like, I think there's three or four more mother crystals. So they're destroying the mother crystals, and they're basically, you know, trying to fulfill what Cid set out to do. Enough so to the point that, like, the people literally call Clive Cid now. It's like the people who Cid was over, like, they now call Clive Cid. So to them, he is Cid. Obviously, they know the old Cid is dead, but he's the new Cid now. So he's doing, you know, what Cid used to do. On top of that, right after that, the old hideout where Cid's office was, like their headquarters, got destroyed by another Dominant, who was like this really big buff guy. I think you only got to see him once at the very beginning of the game, so you probably don't remember seeing him at all. But there's some stuff going on with that guy that you don't really know about, and I can't really explain it, so don't worry about it. Just know that there was the really short-haired lady towards the beginning of the game who was also one of the Dominant. She was like the Dominant of Wind. At some point, we killed her, and I think I explained that to you already, probably in like a Snap video or something. Basically, we killed her. The buff guy who destroyed our hideout got very angry because he found out that we killed her, and he blamed it on Cid and thought Cid killed her. He gets upset, yada, yada, yada. He comes after us with his army and attacks the entire hideout. This is all happening while we're at the capital trying to defeat or destroy the Mother Crystal. At that very same time, Kupka's, or whatever his name, I think his name is Kupka, Lord Kupka, is attacking our headquarters and like beating it to a pummel. So like there wasn't any more headquarters, and he killed a lot of people. Because his Dominant is kind of wild. But anyways, he's a very aggressive man. So fast forward to where we are right now. This is our new hideout, our new headquarters. And we had to rebuild everything because he literally destroyed everything. So like where the hideout used to be, we had to move it like out here. Like these are like the old ruins of the hideout. So now we're like in the middle of a lake now, because everything had to be rebuilt. So, you know, here's Jill. Jill's my right-hand woman, as she kind of was at the time, but now she's definitely my right-hand woman.
Cav should be back by now.
We just finished doing a mission where we had to go to another village that was under attack, and we had to save some people in another little town. I'll watch her. Assuming you're still watching this, I'll watch her snap in a second. A lot of people got killed. There's a new army called the Black Knights or something, the Black Shields, which apparently is the same army group, or they're the Shields of Rosaria, which is the group that Clive used to be a part of when he was younger, before everything happened at Phoenix Gate, before, you know, the big war and the stuff with his brother dying and yada yada yada. So now Clive's like, how dare you guys betray the name of Rosaria, blah blah blah, wonder what the heck is going on here. Come to find out that Clive's like, okay, this has to have something to do with my mother. So I think the bitch mom is about to come back into play, and we're gonna find out more about what happens with her. But I am at the hideout now. What is the new hideout? And I just did a whole bunch of stuff that honestly you don't really need to know. So this is where we are. I'll probably stop playing now though, just because I just mostly wanted to get through all that. I'm gonna talk to Gav real quick. I'm gonna talk to this guy. But I probably won't play any further. Alright, I don't know who else was in here watching, but thanks for watching. I would assume it was probably just you, Anna, hopping on several different devices. But at one point there was three people watching, and then somebody left, and then there was three people watching again. And so I was like, huh, how are there three people watching? I was like, I know Anna's on her iPad because she's in the bath. And then the other one, I was like, she probably left it on in her room, so that's two devices. So I was like, I'm sure two of the devices are probably just her. And then at one point, it went down to one device, and I was like, okay, maybe it wasn't her. And then it went back to two, and I was like, it could be Anna. Maybe she's just switching devices again. And then it went to three again, so I was like, somebody else is here, which is fine, obviously. You know, it's nice that my audience is expanding, but I was like, bro, who the heck else? I was like, who the heck else is here watching? But anyways, I'm done. I'm cutting the stream. Thanks for watching. I'm glad you are caught up with the story now. So next time if you ever watch again, I'll have to catch you up again, because obviously you're not going to be watching me play all the time. I assume more very important things are about to happen. But cool.